Hi, my name is Thomas Kim. In this session of video, we are going to learn how to enumerate combination. Before we develop our algorithm, C++ algorithm, we will learn what is combination first, then I will implement C++ code. Okay. So suppose we have a set, for example, I would say L. The set name would be called L, for example, L. This is a set. That's okay. So we have, for example, four elements, A, B, C, D, four distinct elements. Suppose we have four distinct elements, then we are going to choose three elements out of this set. So we are making subset. Subset like this. If we choose three elements, we can choose A, B, C, then we can choose another subset, A, B, D. We can choose another subset, A, C, D, and then another subset, B, C, D. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the number of ways we can choose three elements out of four distinct, out of a set with four distinct elements. And in mathematical notations, we denote like this. 4, 3. 4, 3 means out of a set with four distinct elements, we are going to choose three, we are going to make a subset with three elements from this set. And as you can see, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So this number is 4. This is called a combination, number of combination. So here we can say if we choose three elements, then only one element D is left here. If we choose this A, B, D, then C is left. C is left. If we choose A, C, D, then B is left. If we choose B, C, D, then A is left. If we see only this part, it means out of a set with four distinct elements, if we choose one element from this set, then we can have 1, 2, 3, 4 different ways. If we compare this equation and this equation, we can see something like this. 4, 3 equals 4, 1 equals 4, like this. So if we let it like this, n number 4, for example, the n number 4, r to number 3, for example, r like this, then we can effectively say n, this number would be n minus 4 minus 3 equals 1. It becomes n minus r equals 1. Okay, so this number can be n minus r, like this. This equation is actually used quite a lot when we do combinations. And also another thing I would like to mention is that so, in this case, NR, please try to understand what it means. We are choosing R elements without repetition, We are choosing R elements without repetition from a set of N distinct elements. We do not choose twice. Without repetition means if we are going to choose 4, 3, we can choose A. It is repetition. We cannot choose repetitions like this. We cannot choose with repetition. So if we are going to choose 3 elements, three elements out of a set with four distinct elements, out of a set with four distinct elements. Please watch this line carefully, okay? From here, if you watch it carefully, you can see A elements are like this, in this set, and in this set there is no A, right? So we can choose like this, we can choose like this. First, we from this set we select the certain element. For example, we choose A. Okay, if we choose A, it becomes something like this. If we choose A, then we have B here, BC, and here, BD, then here, CD. In this set, we removed A. From this set, we removed A, and we select only two. Okay? We remove A, and we select only two elements. This means, since we removed A from this set, we have three elements, and we are choosing two elements like this, only two elements. Then two elements plus. So it composes this part. These three composes this part. And now let's see here. Since we removed A, then we have three elements. And we are choosing three elements. Here, we are choosing three elements, three, like this. If we display it as equation, we can say n minus 1, this is r minus 1, this is nr, r minus 1 plus, this means n minus 1, sorry, this is r is 3. Right? So this way we can, so in the same manner we can say when we have, I will choose like this, when we have nr, we can say we remove, from here we remove one element means n minus 1, then we choose r minus 1, plus, then say n minus 1, we choose R elements like this. Today's video is this equation. This is the topic of this video. If you don't understand, it can be a little bit difficult to follow. So understanding this equation is paramount, most essential and requirement in this how to enumerate combination. So I will write it, I will summarize here. So NCR, NR, we say N minus R. And second, we can say NR, n minus 1, r minus 1, plus n minus 1, r. We can sometimes change the order, it doesn't matter. N minus 1, r, n minus 1, r minus 1. Okay? From this set, I am choosing three elements like this. Three elements, 0, 1, 2, then another three elements, 0, 1, 3, then another three elements, 0, zero, 2, 3, another three elements, 1, two, three. If we choose three elements, then three is left here. If we choose one, 0, 1, 3, then 2 is left. Here, 1 is left. And here, 0 is left. I will label it, I will label this set like B, 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 B. B is a subset, and I will label it, label them 0, 1, 2, 3, and I will call this number like M, M, T, H, M. Okay, so we are going to create two functions. The very first function is this function returns V, and the function name would be ENUM combi, ENUM combi. It will get number of N, the number of this set would be 4, for example, 4. And we are choosing 3 elements, 3, and we are giving m's. If mc is 0, if mc is 0, this set will be returned. This function will return this set if mc is 0. If mc is 1, then this set will return. This function will return this set. And mc is 3, for example, then this set will be returned. Okay? So another thing is that if r is 0, this is number of r. For example, r is 0, then empty set, b would be empty set, no elements. If this r is, for example, I will label it as r. If r is like 4, then all set, all 4 numbers will be, in this case, select 4 elements out of a set with 4 elements, then it returns all elements in this case, so I will label it as r. And this is the number of elements of the set from which we choose the elements, so it will be n. I will label like this. Now you understand the purpose of this ENUM function, right? T. Now I will implement this function here. We will implement using vector and dq. I will use for this set, we will use dq. For this set, we will use vector. Okay? So it will be vector. It returns vector int emum combi. It will get n, r, and m's. Here we set up this set L set first, so it is dq. We say dq, int, l. We can initialize like nth element n like this. Then we initialize this set. We initialize like this set for int I equals 0, I less than n, plus plus I, then l, I, we are assigning elements I. At this point, this L deck is created. Deck is created here. Now, we declare empty set B. We will use vector, like this vector, int, b. Now we reserve space for three elements, r elements. We reserve b, reserve r. We reserve r elements. Now we create here internal function like this void. _enum. This is internal representation. Combi _ like this V L R M's. So we call this function enum combi here B L R R M's like this. At this function actually does the work, so we will return now. Return B. Then this function N. This function returns this B subset. Now we implement this function. I will delete it for the time being. Here, if R is 0, for example, R is 0 means we are choosing no elements at all, then we just return. If R equals 0, then we return. Return. Else if R is the same with number of elements of this cell L size, then we have to copy all elements. We have to copy all elements from this to this. From this set, we have, if the size we are, say for example, this is 4. If we are going to choose 4, then we have to copy all elements. 4. We are choosing all elements. 4. Auto. L. Then we push back B. Push. No, we can say in place back. B. In place back. E. Now we return like this. Now we compute. In this case, this is a base case. Now we compute this number. We compute this number. I would call int count. I would say cnt equals number of combination comb n minus n is, let me see, n is, we compute this number. This number would be element size here, int count combi. We are computing like this. ELE size minus 1. Here we choose I minus 1. We compute this number like this. Here, if M's are less than count, this means we are, if the R is less than, it belongs to here, we select the first element. We select the first element V in place back. We are putting the first element of this step, L, 0. Okay, we put the first element at this set, from here we put the first element, then we remove this element. Here we remove the first element, like this, L, pop front. Here we insert this element to this step, then we remove this element. We removed. Okay? Then we call this function again. Here. Then since we choose one, we can reduce R like this. We are calling this function again like this. ENUM combi here. We said B, L, this set, one element is removed, so we say L, and we choose one element, so we have to R minus 1 like this, and this number doesn't change, M's, like this. We close this block. Here I will keep going this side from else. From this it comes else. So in this case, it belongs to this case. This block belongs to this case. So we have to remove subtract count like this. M's minus equal count. Count is this number. Then say from this case we have to remove this element, right? We have to remove the first element from this. In this case we have to remove the first element. So we remove L pop front. We remove the first element, then we haven't yet chosen. We call this function again. ENUM combi here. We say B L, and we haven't chosen any element yet. So R is the same. It belongs to here, R. And this, so we change the M's like this, M's. Then this function is done. Okay? So we now close. Like this.
Please note that I will use some code from my previous video. Please visit in YouTube. Please visit this YouTube link, my previous video, and download the sample code. We'll be using this sample code in this session. Okay. After downloading. Here, I will unzip it. And I will copy some code from here. I will actually copy all code. Ctrl A, copy. I created an empty solution, empty project. I paste all. Then I remove them. I leave function main here. Save it. Now we are creating how to enumerate enumeration function. I will say SDD. To use this, I need to include the vector SDD and the vector, and I also need the queue. In fact, the queue is not as fast as vector. Vector is actually better and more efficient, but using the queue can be a little bit easier to explain and to understand. So after using the queue, we can optimize to use container vector. So here, std. Vector and t, we can actually make it to template type name t here, t enum combi. I would say recursion like this, and it will have std. No, it will have void. It does not need to return because it will be std vector t b and std dq int l. Then no, this should be t. Then size tr. I will just say int. Okay, int r int m's. Then here. So we will call this function first, template type name t std vector t enum combi recursion t n t r t m's. We'll change it to t. It should be signed integer like this. Then std dq t l n. We are initializing set for size t I. Zero. I would say just t n plus plus I l I equals I. It should be size, I think. Like this. Now we are declaring vector. We reserve vector. R. Now we are calling this function. B L R M's. Now return B. Here, if R equals L size. No, if R equal R is less than or equal to 0, return else if R equals L size then we have to copy all elements. Else, now we compute the count here. This is the function we created, the combination here. L size minus 1, R minus 1. I will say size like this. If m's less than count, I will say t. Or I can say like this t. I don't need it. Then we put v in place back l 0. Then we remove the first element of L. Pop back. No, pop front. Pop front. Then we call V L R minus 1, because we inserted one element to V and we removed, so we have the R minus 1 here, M's. Else here we compute M's count, we decrease M's, else pop front, we remove the first element, then we call again p l here r m's. Now we completed. Now let's try this function. We have to call this function here. Std cout enum combi recursion from, we will have three elements. Then we select all three, then zeros. Why it gives like this? Okay, I will create functions for vector std or string os operator, the CD or stream, OS, constant, template, type name T, STD, vector T, V, if P empty, return OS auto last element VP and minus minus OS pro auto ITR V begin ITR last element plus plus ITR OS ITR OS last element okay return OS now let's run it Zero, one, two. Because we started with three elements, now we are doing loop. We will use int max t n. Cout C STD Cout STD Cin Okay AGAIN PO NT max t r equals we will compute int max max t cmb combi rational n no okay n no we will use it in the loop So, anti max max tr CMB equals combi rational n r here 0 r equals purpose I. No, this should be CMB. CMB. Here. STD. Cout. NR. No, we just say I okay, let's run it. If n equals 0 and r equals 0, return here, we say go to like this. Sorry, we have to say n r m's. I will say m's. Like this. Oh, 3, 2. So we are selecting from three different elements, a set of three different elements, three distinct elements. We are choosing 2, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 2. Like this. Now select 5, 1, like this, 5, 2, we have, like this is 10 sets, 10 combinations, and 5, 3, so 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 3, 0, 1, 4, you are selecting combinations like this. 5, 4. You are selecting 4 elements. 5, 5. You are selecting all elements, the zeros. So let's pick something here. I have some warnings here. From max t to int. Rational, this rational combination. From anti-max to anti-possible. Well, it gives error message. Here. Anti-max T. We are doing like this. Now build once again. Yeah. Size T. Now compile once again. I do like this. Okay, no error. So here we used recursion like this. We are actually using recursion here. I will try once again. Big number, for example. Here 10, prime out of 10, we are enumerating 5. Like this. We are enumerating. For example, 3, 4, 3, we can test it like this. Now we are turning it to loop. Using recursion is we are using recursion. Using recursion is slow, not optimized. If we examine it carefully, we can turn it to loop like this. I copied it. Then I will change it to like this. Here, I change it to loop like this. And loop. It will also return std vector like this, t. And we copy initial part here. Initial part. I copied, paste here, and in this case it is null set. We have to return b, and here we have to return or break. I will make it to loop. Like see, 2. I am changing it to loop. Watch carefully. Here. While. True. Here. We are returning this vector b. Here. Return b. Then here. We will break. Break out of loop. And here we will break. And here, instead of calling this, we will change it like this. Here, if we watch it carefully, minus r. So we don't need to call it again. We are doing just loop. And here, we don't need to call it. So I effectively change from recursion to loop. Okay, so we don't need it here, b. It should be tn, tr. M's, like this. Okay, we saved. Now we are calling m combi. The same way as we do here. STD, CR. N, R, M's, STD, and there. I would say recursion. Recursion, and here loop. Now let's run it. Say loop and recursion, the result are actually the same. I will try to align them. I'll try it. Okay, they are aligned. See, we are using recursion, we are losing loop. Loop is actually much faster and much more efficient. So whenever possible, you have to use loop instead of recursion. Finally, we are using a data structure called DEC, DQ. But DQ is not very optimized, not very efficient. Using a vector can be much faster, for example. But in this session, I will conclude this session because it took so much time and it is a little bit complicated for you. The algorithm itself is not difficult if you understand this algorithm. If you understand, after understanding recursion, then I converted from recursion to loop, like this. Loop is actually much faster. Thank you for watching. In future videos, I will optimize this enumeration, enumeration of combination. I will also film about enumeration of permutations. Enumeration of permutations is a little bit more complex. Thank you for watching.